Oh my god. Jesus fucking Christ. Expensive ass camera almost fell over. From stabbing the fucking chest. Hey guys, just want to let you know this is a bit of a long video. I want to cover both the beginner and advanced methods of Melodyne all in one video. If you want to hear the beginner section, just listen from here. If you want to hear the advanced section, just jump to this timestamp on the screen. Thank you for your patience and enjoy the video. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Food Review. Just kidding, today I'll be doing a walkthrough of Melodyne. I'll be showing you guys how to tune a basic vocal, just like I did in this review up here. Also, later on in the video, I'll be using Melodyne to fix up a project that is much more complicated. One with multiple layers, with me singing on it. You won't want to miss it.
It's pretty bad. My singing is really bad.
Let's go. Alright, so you guys may have seen this in my review about Melodyne. This is the vocal I fixed up in the video. It is an acapella I found online, and maybe one of the worst ones I've ever heard.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. Went to bed, bumped his head, and couldn't get up in the morning.
Anyway, I fixed it up in that video. I'm gonna show you guys how to do that real quick because I feel like that'd be a great place to start. Definitely much easier than working on something with multiple takes and layering and whatnot. So we're gonna right click the file and we're gonna go open with. And we're gonna choose default program. Yada yada. Basically, I'm just gonna pick Melodyne. Alright, and we're in here. So when you open up a file in Melodyne, it'll usually try to guess what kind of file it is. If it's percussive, melodic, etc. Mine seems to have guessed that it was melodic. But if you want to change that, which you want to, because there are a bunch of different algorithms. So if we're gonna work on the tuning, we're gonna want to either use the melodic or the polyphonic algorithms. To keep it simple, we'll just work with melodic. Okay, so we have this singing here. It looks like it's trying to be an E minor. If you want to change the scale that you're trying to tune to, you click over here on the key you're trying to go to. So say we're going to E minor, click on E, then you go to E minor, or whatever scale you're in. Also worth mentioning, you're going to need to know just very light basic music theory in order to work this program. Just very light though. You can work it without any really. You just have to follow instructions, but the only thing that's happened so far is we've just changed the scale. So we're going to select all by pressing Ctrl A. Then we're gonna go to edit, then we're gonna go to quantization macros, then you go to correct pitch, we're gonna click on snap to E minor. This will make sure that all the notes that we correct will go to E minor and not just whatever note they're nearest to. We're gonna turn up the pitch center correction to 100% and the pitch drift to 100%. We may wanna dial these back if it sounds too robotic or extreme. It really depends on the settings you're going for, but I'll start with this for now. All right, now let's listen to it back.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring.
All right, so that note sounds, it's not out of tune, but it's the wrong note. So we're gonna turn this note down to either F sharp or E.
No.
Try F sharp first.
The old man is snoring.
That sounds bad, so let's put that one down to E.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. Went to bed, bumped his head, and couldn't get up in the morning.
Make this last F sharp here an E instead. Okay, so let's do it one more time.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. Went to bed, bumped his head, and couldn't get up in the morning.
Much better. We can also change the pitch modulation as well if we want. These are all the tools here. There's the main tool, the pitch tool, the formant tool, amplitude, time, etc. We're only gonna work with the pitch tools. I'm gonna check the pitch modulation here. You can check what it is by mouse hovering over it. Then you can check the percentage here, or you can also just mouse over it. So let's try turn down the pitch modulation, see how it sounds.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring.
So that's good if you're going for more of a robotic T-Pain effect. So we're going to want to keep our pitch modulation. Let's keep it at 70 or 80%. I think that'll be more natural.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring.
Let's compare it, guys, before.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring.
And after.
It's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring.
Hi, this is Overdub Weaver, and I renamed it by right-clicking on it in case that wasn't obvious. It's okay, outies. Okay, so we're gonna export that. Alright, now let's get this shit off my fucking computer.
Dude, oh my god!
Alright, now part two. Advanced Melody. Alright, so I have this project file here I'm gonna work on. I made the beat. I made the singing. Pretty bad, but we're gonna make it sound pretty good. I'm gonna show you guys a little trick right here. If you don't know what key you're in and you're too lazy to figure it out, you can just export chords or whatever you have and open it in Melodyne, and it'll tell you an estimation of the key. Might not be correct, especially if using non-diatonic chord progressions, but just something worth mentioning. All right, so it looks like we're in D major, so I'm gonna be tuning everything to D major. So this is the project file right here, as is. I just have the hook looped. The beat I made and two takes of me singing. One in a low voice and one in a high voice. They're both pretty bad, but the high voice especially is really bad. So we're gonna tune them both up. So D major, remember that. So we can either work with Melodyne as a standalone or we can work with it through Rewire. So I'm gonna show you guys how to work with it through Rewire right now. You guys should have Melodyne in your VST folder. Mine is right here. I'm gonna drag it on the audio file I wanna correct. I have the other ones muted, by the way. As you can see, the little window opened. Another thing you'll notice is there's a different button here. It says transfer. Wow. So we're gonna click transfer, and then we're gonna press play. From the beginning. That's key.
Would you get out my way? I be smoking all day.
As you can see, my vocal take is here at Melodyne, and it read it as D major, which is the right key for us. I believe it's actually in B minor, but it keeps reading it as D major, so we're just gonna refer to it as D major. Alright, so I'm just gonna select all, and I'll go to edit, go to quantization macros, go to correct pitch, snap to D major, and then I'm gonna turn all this stuff up. Let me see how it sounds. Might have to do some adjustments. Yeah. Alright, so I adjusted the notes there till they sounded like the melody I was going for. Now I'm gonna fix the rest of it, the takes here. You can just drag the notes up and down, as you can see here. And if you need to separate them, you can do that here with this button. If you aren't sure what something is, you can just mouse over it and it'll tell you. So there's a note separation tool. So if I want to separate this, I can just click, double click here, and it'll separate that note, and I can split the tuning there if I want. But I think it's fine, so we don't need to split anything. Now I'm gonna try mess with the pitch modulation. Let's turn it down to 50% and see what that sounds like. So I select it all, change to the pitch modulation here, and turn it down 50%.
Would you get out my way?
So I think I actually need a little bit of pitch modulation on this middle note right here, the C sharp. So I'm gonna select everything except for the C sharp. So I'm gonna Control A, or select everything with the mouse, and then I'm gonna hold Control, and then I'm gonna click off all these C sharps here. Boom. Now I'm gonna do the same thing again. So I turned down the pitch modulation for everything but that note.
Would you get out my way? I be smoking all day.
Would you? And then maybe I can adjust this one independently. So I'm just gonna select that area, the C sharps. Then adjust the pitch modulation. I'm gonna set it to 100. That way it was the default. And then turn it down. Let's try 70.
Would you get out my way?
That's good.
All day.
Okay, I'm gonna select this note and turn it down more. The pitch modulation was really fucking that up there. So I'm gonna put that one at like 4%.
Would you get my way?
I think there's this sounds a little inhuman right here. I'm gonna turn up the pitch modulation there.
Would you get my way? I be smoking all day.
You have to play with the settings a little bit to get it sounding how you want, but this is pretty close to how I want it now, I think. Oh my god. And if you're an idiot like me, you'll press Control Z and undo the whole thing, so you have to start over. Fuck this shit. Alright, then from there we're gonna have to route it back into Ableton. So in order to do that, we're gonna make a new audio track, press Control T, and then we're gonna pick the track that we had it on. So for me it'd be this track named track 1. So I pick track 1, set in, and then I have record enabled, and then I'm gonna press record up here. I'm gonna just record this whole thing in here. You're recording the output from Melodyne back into Ableton. Then we can mute the other track. I'm gonna tune this other track I have real quickly. This is the high one. I'm gonna name it track 2. Essentially, I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm gonna drag Melodyne on this. Then I'm gonna transfer the whole thing in.
Would you get out my way? I'd be smoking all day.
Alright, we got it recorded. I stopped it. Now let's check out the notes in here. Oh, it still thinks it's D major. Essentially, it's just going to be copying the same thing as the other one, but an octave up. So I'm going to quantize it real quick. Boom, snap it. 100%, 100%. Then we're going to look at the melody. This looks pretty close. Okay, I'm going to have to move this note up here and this one down here. I already have a feeling I know how this is going to go. Alright, nice. The next I'm gonna start messing with the pitch modulation. So I'm gonna Control A. Then I'm gonna change to the pitch modulation tool right here. Then I'm gonna turn it down to 60%. Let's see how that sounds.
Would you get out my way? I'd be smoking all day. Would you get out my way?
Sounds way better, right? Insane. I think I'm good with it as it is, so I'm just gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna bring it back into Ableton, make a new audio track, Control T, then I'm gonna click track 2, then click in. I wanna make sure it's post mixer, then enable it, then hit record.
Get out my way. I'd be smoking all day. Would you get out my way? I'd be smoking all day. Get out my way. I'd be smoking all day. Would you get out my way? I'd be smoking all day.
Okay, that's it for this video, guys. Hopefully you guys learned something on how to tune vocals with Melodyne, or how to operate it, hopefully. A lot of people have been asking me questions about how to use this software, and honestly, I don't think it's too difficult. It's just a little bit strange because it's tuning software, and there's lots of tuning options that we never really hear, like pitch modulation, pitch drift. That's never really something we have to deal with too much in the music production world. Yeah, hopefully this helps you guys out, and if I ever release the full song for this song I've worked on in this project, then I'll link it down in the description. If not, then I guess this is where you can listen to it. If you guys enjoyed this video, let me know. My name is Weaver Beats. I upload music production videos twice or three times a week, depending on if I can get the work done. Join my Discord for music production discussions, and check out Bloom Audio, bloom-audio.com, for mixing and mastering. Very affordable, quality, by me. Make sure to tune in next time when I pass out from heat exhaustion. Alright, hopefully that joke made you guys laugh, because that actually hurt.
So I like listening to things. I could say to you guys, you know, listen to Eric. You can check him out down in the description. When I'm pushing forward, man, all the shims I'm seeing, the eyes of a demon, I'm already defeated, I'm getting the beat, and I'm hitting it loud.